Hi there mga kakuda. 1, 2, 3. Hi there mga kakuda. And we decided to bought some plants. Kasi gusto namin na magkaroon ng mga plants. Ang gulo ko mag-start ngayon. Hi there mga kakuda and welcome again to my channel. For this vlog, we are going to talk about plants. Lumapit na ako kasi ang hirap po mag-vlog. Ayan, basang-basa ng pawis. Oh, ayan. Basa. Ang init. If you watched my second vlog, nakita nyo doon na one of the gifts that I gave to myself is yung nakuha ko na snake plant. Simula nung pwede na mga mag-deliver and we are able to get outside of our house, we ordered some plants because we decided not just to put aesthetic sa bahay, but of course, to make our house more lively, to make the house even good for our dad as well, because based sa NASA, as per NASA po, no, it is recommended for you to have 6 to 8 plants inside a particular room. Having indoor plants, it helps our house to eliminate the pollutants in the air. Some of the pollutants that we have are benzene, ammonia, saline. Ano pa ba? Letter F tsaka T. Basta, agayon ko na lang mga kakuda. I will post it here. Ayan. So we have the abbreviation letter B, letter A, letter X, letter F, and letter T. Ayan. So, and what I will do is every time that I'm going to talk about a particular plant, I'll just put there what particular toxic ang na-eliminate niya or natatanggal niya sa air. At least to help you and decide kung ano man ang possible na indoor plants na pwede sa inyo. For our first plant, we have here the snake plant, or what we also called as the mother-in-law's tongue.
Oh no!
Well, that's my question as well. Kung nagtatanong kayo, bakit mother-in-law's tongue? Hindi ko rin po alam kung bakit ganun yung tawag sa kanya. Pero that's the other name of snake plant. I really want to have this plant inside my room because based from my research, it will help to absorb radiation. So ako, nasa isip ko, lalagay ko siya sa tabi ng sa table ko, malapit sa my laptop, of course, because we're doing work from home. So, I think this will be a good health. Maganda yung benefits niya. And, isa pa sa mga natatanggal na mga toxic or pollutants in the air ng snake plant ay makita nyo po dito sa baba. Ayan. Yan pa po. Okay? So, ang description din na binigay nila sa snake plant is easy to take care but hard to kill. Easy to take care kasi hindi mo siya masyadong kailangan laging diligan. When it comes sa sunlight, kaya niya matolerate yung sobrang init. Pero I recommend, personally recommend, na wag naman yung tutok na tutok sa araw. And it is also easy to propagate. All you just need to do is to cut it and then put it in the soil or at least put it in a container with water, then antay nyo siya na magkaroon ng roots. Also, this is one of the plants then that based from NASA will help us to purify the air. So, pasok siya sa NASA. For our second plant, we have kinuha sa ilalim. We have the peace lily. Okay? So, peace lily is also one of the air purifying plants based from NASA that highly recommendable to have inside our room or inside our house. Itong peace lily na to, we bought it as one, but we're able to propagate it. So nakita nyo naman, naging dalawa na siya. What is really unique about this particular plant, malalaman mo kapag kailangan mo na siyang diligan. So yung dahon niya, babagsak siyang ganyan. Ayan. Tapos kapag nadiligan mo na siya, tatayo na siya ulit. That's very unique for this plant. Kung mapapansin nyo po, no, yung sa peace lily namin, share ko sa inyo, nagkaroon ng maraming mga butas. Ayan, nagkaroon siya ng maraming mga something sa leaves niya. And when I did the research about it, because of it's about the pest na kumakain mismo nung halaman. So, I was really surprised because when we put it inside the room, wala naman kami mga pests inside the house. So, when you purchase it, yung pest nakasama na siya. Probably kasi kasama siya sa maraming mga halaman din. We use this washing soap. We just make sure na wala siyang chlorine para hindi mamuti yung halaman. So, hinalo namin siya sa tubig and we sprayed it to the plants, to every plants that we have to remove or to kill the bugs or yung mga pest na nasa lupa at nasa mga dahon. For our third plant, we have here the aloe vera. Ayan. Actually, this is our, I think, fifth aloe vera. So, we're able to propagate it. Sobrang dali lang po niyang paramihin. Nakakatuwa ang aloe vera. Sabi nga nila, no, it is really recommended sa kitchen and at some point sa bathroom din. So, these are the toxins in the air na tinatanggal din po ng aloe vera. Ayan. Mas madali ulit siyang ituro kaysa banggitin. Ayan. So, and aloe vera is also one of the air purifiers recommended by NASA as well. For our next plant, we have the fortune plant. Ayan po. Ayan. Baba ko po siya mabigat. Hindi kayang buhatin habang nagsasalita. Okay. So, for fortune plant, one of the benefits that fortune plant, having a fortune plant inside your house is it purifies the air din. But if you will Google, it says that it is somewhat a lucky charm. A plant that will help you to have more wealth or to be lucky. Ayan. Ako po personally, no, I'm not really particular about it. We bought this because maganda yung itsura ng fortune plant and madali siyang alagaan, madaling ipropagate. Once you have the stem here, ayan, pwede nyo po siyang i-separate na at pwede na po kayo magtanim ng panibago. So, mabilis siyang paramihin din at some point. Mm. So, that's actually our main goal when we bought it. Kasi for me, no, I really don't believe in luck. I really don't believe in depending on plants for me to be wealthy. I always believe in hard work and faith. To be always be excellent in your craft, to be passionate in what you do, in your hobbies, in your business, to always give the best that you can in everything that you do. Plus, to have deeper faith in the one and great provider. Ako po, lagi ko pong iniisip, no? My great provider is better than any plants or anything that the world can offer for me to be lucky or to have something in hand, diba? Alay ko pong sinasabi sa sarili ko, no? More than luck, I always believe in terms of blessing and favor coming from one my God provider. Coming from my great provider. So, naisingit ko lang naman po. Ano naisingit? Next, and for our next plant, we have here the areca palm. Areca? Arcea? Basta palm po. Okay, so this is one of, also one of the indoor plants that NASA recommended for air purifying. Po siyang alagaan, hindi mahirap. Ang kailangan lang tandaan, dapat hindi siya nakalagay sa direct sunlight. So it is really recommended na mga nasa likod ng kurtina or sa mga plants, sa mga places na walang masyadong araw. That's why it's really recommended for you to put it inside your living room. Doon po siya. And some of the toxins that na some of the toxins na tinatanggal din po ng halaman nito ay ito. Basahin niyo na lang po ulit. Ayan. And another indoor plants that we have is these two plants. Ayan po siya. Kaso lang hindi ko po alam yung pangalan. Binigay lang siya sa amin ng kapitbahay namin. We're able to propagate it accordingly, repot it, and voila! Tumubo naman po siya. But really don't know kung ano yung pangalan ng ano to, ng halaman na to. So, if you know the name of this plant, and this one as well, kindly comment below. thank you in advance sa mga magko-comment po. And for the last plant, mga kakuda, that we have in our house, is the saloom. Ayan. as of the moment po, no, ito po talaga ang pinaka-paborito ko ngayon as of the moment. I'm really, really happy to have this plant inside my room. Nasa room ko po to. Katabi ko po ng mismong kama ko po siya. Ayan. I believe this breed is Brazilian Silawum. Ayan. So, meron po siyang ganyang klaseng, ano, leaves. Very, very unique leaves. Nakakatawa siya. Okay. So, one of the benefits, again, ng Silawum is that, of course, it purifies the air. And some of the, again, the pollutants that tinatanggal niya ay nandito po. Ayan. Basahin na lang po ulit. But, yung leaves kasi ng Silawum, it serves as the vacuum itself. Ano ba yung pawis? Ayan. It will serve as the vacuum to really take away all of the pollutants in the air. So, maganda siya kasi it regulates the air inside your room and it will help you to have breathing, good breathing during night. Ayan. So, ayan. I really hope mapadami pa namin tong part na to. Okay. Itong mga plants na meron po ako right now, I just ordered that with the reseller in our village, dito sa Lancaster. Ayan. But if you are living somewhere in Manila, I would like to recommend to you the Adrianos home. So, you can check the description for their Facebook page and their YouTube as well. I ordered a zebra plant to them. So, by the way, this is not sponsored by Adrianos home, but I just really loved their plants. Ang gaganda ng mga pots po nila. And they're really taking good care of the plants before they sell it to you. So please do check their Facebook page and their YouTube channel as well. Okay?
3 days later.
Finally, ito na ang ating zebra plant. And look, and as you can see, no, yung Adrianos, they gave us plant care guide for zebra. Ang sabi nila, the water it when it's fully dry. And the light should be bright, direct sun, and humidity is normal. I really appreciate this one. No? PM us when you need help. So, nakakatuwa kasi if by any chance, nag-start pa lang kayo na magkaroon ng mga plants, but you don't know what to do, you can really PM them. Wow. So, ang ganda lang na ano, customer service ng Adrianos. So, this is it. Thank you, Adrianos. Maraming salamat. Thank you. So that's it mga kakuda. I hope you enjoy our vlog for today about plants. I believe this will not be the first and the last time that we're going to do this because again, I'm going to purchase some plants more. Wala naman po akong bala kumplituhin yung sinabi ng NASA ng mga air purifier plants. But malay natin, di ba? Pwede naman. If by any chance, makahanap tayo ng medyo affordable na mga plants, why not? Okay? So, I really hope you enjoy and learn something for this vlog. If you haven't watched my vlog yet, other vlogs, please feel free to check our description. Follow me on my Instagram account as well. And then please don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and comment on this particular vlog. So, magkita-kita po tayo again sa sulod natin ng vlog. I really hope na next time, mas marami tayong halaman na ma-review at mga items or best practices that we can apply sa mga nagsisimulang magkaroon ng indoor plants kagaya ko. So, maraming salamat guys!